Perspective is when artists use drawing tools or drawing tricks to make something that is 2D or flat look like it's 3D, look like it has depth and distance in it. This is Mrs. Shoemaker. I can prove it. Look, see. Okay. I knew people were going to ask that. All right. So to quickly review fourth grade, after you have all your materials, you put a vanishing point someplace on your paper. Because of the glare from the screen, I'm going to go over here a little bit so you can see it better, about the size of a freckle. And then I'm going to pick out my straight-sided shapes. I'm going to do my straight-sided shapes first. Some classes are 4 straight-sided shapes minimum, and some classes are 5 straight-sided shapes minimum. Can you do more? Yes, absolutely. Straight-sided shapes, you can pick anything on here that has straight sides. So any of these guys that are straight, pentagon, square, triangle, hexagon, slide down over here, rhombus, little baby triangle, all the polygons and the parallelograms. Anything that has a straight-sided shape is fair game. You can use it. Let's start over here with a square just to review how we do this. Get that in the shot. That would be good. All right, there we go. Anytime you're making a mark after this dot, anything else, you've got to use your template. Use your safety geometry template. Draw light. I'm going to do mine a little bit darker so it shows up on the screen, but you want to do yours kind of light. So if you want to erase, that you can. Once you have your shape on there, you have to figure out which parts are going to go to the vanishing point. On this guy, this one, and this one are going to go to the vanishing point. So I'm going to line up the corner and the dot and the vanishing point and connect it. I'm going to connect the dots. Connect, connect, and connect. I don't have to worry about the other one because you can't see him. He's behind all this. You can't see him. All right, another one. I'm going to do a cheater one on purpose. Let's do a rectangle. All right, for the rectangle, only this one and this one this time are going to go to the vanishing point. Line it up. Get it right the first time. Take your time. And connect. And connect. When you're doing circles, circles only ever have 2 lines that go from the circle to the vanishing point. I'm going to put a circle over here. Let's do a big guy. Only the outside edges have to go to the vanishing point. Let's see if I can zoom in a little bit here. Only the outside edges. So I get my vanishing point and the outside edge as close as I can get, but I don't want to go inside the circle. And connect. And then down here, I do the same thing. I get it lined up, slide it down, slide it down, slide it down until it's just in the right spot. Make sure it's connected. That looks good. That looks good. And then draw the line. After you have all your straight-sided shapes and all your circles that you need, which I do not, but once you have all of yours, then you're going to use your Sharpie to trace all of these guys. Everything you just did in pencil, you're going to trace again, but with a Sharpie. Every time this Sharpie touches the paper, it has to also touch the template. It's not allowed out without the template. So you have to find the same shapes again, match it up. That's the square I used before. Line it up and trace it again. Boom, 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 boom. It's actually pretty quick. Trace your same lines again. I did a line there, connect it. I did a line here, connect it. Everything goes to the vanishing point. All right, down here for my rectangle, find the rectangle again, get it lined up, trace it, and then I'm going to connect again. Boom, boom. Once you have everything traced, you're going to get an eraser and you're going to look for any pencil lines that might still be showing. If you actually went really slow on your tracing with your Sharpie, you should not have very many lines that you need to erase. I have a smidge of something down here I have to get. Double check for any lines that you got rid of that you didn't want earlier or you changed your mind on a shape. Just make sure everything looks good. It's a craftsmanship thing. Real artists go back and they clean up the project and they make it look nice so that it make it look like they know what they're doing. You want it to look nice. It's like dressing up for church. Make sure it looks nice. Okay, once you get that far, the next step is pattern on the shape face. You can make up your own patterns. You can also borrow my line and pattern cheat sheets. But each one of these guys needs to have his own pattern. If you feel comfortable doing it with a Sharpie, you can do it with a Sharpie. You don't have to do it with pencil first. Personally, I kind of like doing it with a Sharpie myself, so I don't have to worry about all the smeary graphite pencil lines. I'm not a big fan of that. But you're going to hop in here and you're going to add some fun little designs. Each one of these needs to be different. Let me say that again. Each one of these needs to be different. I don't want to have, you know, seven shapes and they're all checkerboard. That doesn't work. You need to come up with different designs, one different one for each one. Again, if you need help, you can borrow my line and pattern cheat sheets. All right, one more. Once you have all these guys done, you're going to break out your colored pencils. Whenever you have this part done, you can go ahead and get the colored pencils. You don't have to ask me. One tray per table. As soon as you have all of your patterns done, no pencil lines, you can get your colored pencils and start coloring just the shape face, just the part that has the actual shape. Do not do this part yet. Don't do that part without me. Just do that part right there. That's all you do. You just get these guys all colored in. Once you have all of your shape faces designed and colored in, then you need to stop. And you're going to need to talk to Mrs. Shoemaker, talk to me about how you're going to do these sides. That next part is the shading part from light to dark or from dark to light, really, the value part. So I'm going to do that in another video.